may surprise you to know, but tourists travel the world to see bridges. The Golden Gate, the Forth Bridge, Tower Bridge in London. But what also may surprise you is the Scottish Borders has more than its fair share of interesting, influential and superlative bridges. And most of them are a bit more ancient than the ones I've mentioned previously. But let's go and take a look at some today. This is Ashes Steel near Galla Shields. It's actually the home of Sir Walter Scott, the big house over there on the hill before he built Abbotsford. But it's the bridge at Ashes Steel here that I'm interested in today. Doesn't look like much from the road. Carries a minor road to a housing estate now. But this really is a fantastic bridge with a fantastic story. When you get down on the waterside here, you can begin to appreciate the scale of that rubble built arch. It's not the usual steep arch you see on most bridges like that. It's very long, very wide. And it was in fact, at the time of its construction in 1847, the longest single span arch bridge in the world. Imagine that. Still carrying big traffic today. The bridge that you see here is actually the second incarnation of the bridge. It's such an ambitious span, such a real feat of engineering for its day. 1847, there was a builder from Darnick near Melrose that made it. Their first attempt was almost complete, but when they removed the supportive scaffolding, the entire structure collapsed. They just went straight back to building it again, and what you see there is the result. So there you go, Ashes Steel Bridge, the longest single span arch rubble bridge in the world when it was constructed, and still one of the longest to this very day. But as per usual, what I'm looking for is something a bit grander, a bit less well known, and a bit more of a wow factor. Because you see, the tallest bridge in the Scottish Borders was also the tallest bridge in the world at the time of its construction. But where is it? Or what is it? This is the Scottish Borders Menage a Trois of bridges at Leaderfoot near St Boswells. Three engineering feats for the price of one. New in the foreground, very old in the middle, and kind of middle-aged at the back. It's a middle-aged one that I'm interested in today. At 38 metres above the river at its tallest point, surely this Leaderfoot Viaduct is the highest bridge in the Scottish Borders. When you're a wee bit away from it, it does actually look a wee bit, dare I say, spindly and fragile, but when you get right up underneath it, you realise the real scale and magnitude of the structure. Really awe-inspiring. I wouldn't mind getting on top of it, but I don't actually think there's access to the structure these days. But looking at the columns there, I think I might be able to climb it. So I'll give it a go and, you know, I'll see you at the top if I make it. Maybe they'll believe it if I make it look like I've climbed up the ridge. Right, I will. I will. Ah, I bet I will. I think the authorities are quite keen to keep you off the bridge because they've heavily sort of barbed wired at me. So I would need to climb along quite a bit of the bridge on the outside to get on it, so I'm not going to bother. I could have climbed up it if I'd wanted to, but I was a bit tired, you know. Anyway, let's go back down. It was opened in 1863 to carry a branch of the railway line from the East Coast Main Line at Reston down to the Waverley Line at Carlisle via Duns, Greenlaw and St Boswells. But is it the tallest bridge? Is this the tallest bridge in the Scottish Borders? Surely. What? It isn't the tallest bridge. There's another bridge a whole 40 centimetres taller on the Tweed. Where is it? This is it, the Royal Border Bridge in Berwick-upon-Tweed, built in 1850, a whole 13 years before Leaderfoot, but at 38.4 metres, a whole 40 centimetres taller. Wow, it really is an engineering marvel, and still carries the East Coast Main Line between Edinburgh and London to this day. For me, it doesn't look as tall as the Leaderfoot Viaduct. I think that's because the pillars are far wider and far more substantial at the bottom, so it just doesn't give it that impression of height. But it certainly is taller. But there's one small problem with this bridge in Berwick-upon-Tweed, and some of you may have picked up on that already, and it's to do with the geography of where Berwick-upon-Tweed is. I mean, you hear stuff all the time, don't you, on radio borders about Tustaine Motors and shops just off the Skrimmerston roundabout and stuff like that. So I really just thought that Berwick was in the Scottish borders, but I was just speaking to a local guy there and he was saying, no, apparently the English army took it back again in 1480 or something like that. So really Berwick isn't even in the Scottish borders, so I can't really count this bridge as the highest one. But it's irrespective. Because there is another bridge, another stone arch bridge, which is taller than this or Leaderfoot, and it's 100% definitely within the Scottish borders. But where is it? At 39 metres, 39, our next bridge dwarfs anything on the Tweed. It was built in 1794, so it's far older too. It's pretty much unheard of, I have to say, and I've only found out about it myself in the last couple of weeks, and I've still never seen it, so I'm looking forward to this. Now I've travelled not too far up the coast from Berwick now to Pease Bay Holiday Camp. And behind Pease Bay there's this dense piece of vegetation called Pease Dean. And apparently somewhere in Pease Dean here is what was the tallest bridge in the world in 1794. But where the hell is it? We'll be right back. I'm pretty sure this isn't it. Seriously, how hard can it be to find the world's biggest bridge? As if from nowhere, I think I'm finally beginning to see the arches of the bridge just tucked away right in the middle of this woodland. Astounding. Absolutely astounding. Check it out, the tallest bridge in the world in 1794. Still currently the tallest bridge in the Scottish Borders. What an amazing setting. If you're approaching by road, you probably wouldn't think anything of it. It's just a tiny little country bridge. But you're driving over history, you're driving over civil engineering superlatives. Definitely one of these structures where just standing here looking down at it, it's making me feel busy even though I'm miles away from it. Stunning, absolutely stunning. I can't believe I've never heard of this before. I can't believe it's not a big tourist attraction. I think I've maybe done enough flying without wings montages recently, but I might try and think of another song. Just remember, guys, the Scottish Borders is crammed full of picturesque, stunning bridges like this one over and above the four I've focused on today. Please go and discover them for yourself.